Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. Today's topic of our discussion is respiration and its type. These are the contents of our discussion. What is respiration? Respiration is one of the characteristics of living organism and it is performed by every single cell of living organism. We know our body requires some energy to carry out some functions like growth and development, protein synthesis, muscle contraction, active transport of molecules, etc. These all functions require energy in the form of ATP, and it is provided by a process called as respiration. Respiration happens in plants as well as in animal cells inside a small cell organelle known as mitochondria. Now, what does respiration basically mean? The release of energy when food substances are broken down by oxidation into simpler substances such as carbon dioxide and water with release of lots of energy. This energy is in the form of ATP. Respiration is a chemical process. In this reaction, glucose comes from the food that we consume and oxygen comes from the breathing. These two combine and form carbon dioxide and water with lots of energy in the form of ATP. You can see the respiration reaction. See here the reaction C6H12O6. That is glucose plus 6 molecules of oxygen will combine and form 6 molecules of carbon dioxide and 6 molecules of water with release of lots of energy in the form of ATP. जो भी फूड हम कंज्यूम करते हैं वो डाइजेस्ट होके ग्लूकोज में कन्वर्ट होता है एंड ये ग्लूकोज ऑक्सीजन जो ब्रीदिंग करके हम लेते हैं उसके साथ कंबाइन होके वो बनाता है कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वाटर एंड सम एटीपी. नाउ देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन. वन इज एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन एंड अनादर इज एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इज द रेस्पिरेशन व्हिच टेक्स प्लेस इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इज द रेस्पिरेशन व्हिच टेक्स प्लेस इन एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. Now, moving to the next slide. Respiration takes place inside the mitochondria. See here the structure of mitochondria. Mitochondria is a double membrane cell organelle, which means it consists of two membranes that are outer membrane, inner membrane, and the space between in these two membrane is intermembrane space. Inner membrane is the site for electron transport chain, and inside to this inner membrane there is presence of semi-solid fluid known as matrix. Mitochondrial matrix contains mitochondrial DNA, ribosomes, some soluble enzymes, small organic molecules, nucleotide cofactors and some inorganic ions. Mitochondria ये एक ऐसा cell organelle है जिसके पास cell के DNA के अलावा भी उसका खुद का DNA भी होता है. Mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell because we know ATP is referred as currency of the cell and these ATPs are generated by mitochondria. That's why mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell. क्योंकि जो भी energy cell को लगती है वो ATP के form में लगती है और ये ATP mitochondria से मिलती है. इसीलिए हम ATP को cell की currency और mitochondria को powerhouse of the cell कहते हैं. Moving to the next slide, what is aerobic respiration? So the name aero indicates air, that means oxygen. जो भी respiration air के presence में होगा उसे हम कहेंगे aerobic respiration. The definition is the release of relatively large amount of energy by the breakdown of food substances in the presence of oxygen occurs in the mitochondria. It is similar to the combustion of fuel. See the reaction of aerobic respiration. Glucose plus oxygen will form carbon dioxide and water with relatively large amount of energy. This glucose is provided by food and oxygen is provided by breathing. These two will combine to form carbon dioxide and water and energy in the form of ATP. Now, next question arises in our mind, how do we get the oxygen? And that is from breathing. See, you might think breathing and respiration is one and same thing, but actually it is not. These are two different phenomena. Breathing is a part of respiration, so don't get confused with these two. The oxygen we get from the breathing, and the breathing is consisting of two things: inhalation, that is inhaling, and exhalation, that is exhaling. Inhaling or inhalation में होता क्या है, जो भी हम breathe in करते हैं उससे oxygen lungs के अंदर आता है, और exhaling या फिर एक्सहेलेशन से ब्रीद आउट करके लंग्स से कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड हम एटमॉस्फेयर में टेक आउट करते हैं. इसे कहते हैं हम ब्रीदिंग, एंड ब्रीदिंग इज नेसेसरी फॉर रेस्पिरेशन. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज प्लांट रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. यस, प्लांट आल्सो हैव देयर रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम लाइक ह्यूमंस. Plants also respire. See the point. Plants respire all the time, just like other living organisms. During the day, plants do respiration as well as do photosynthesis. Daytime mein plants respiration and photosynthesis dono process continue karte hain. But during the night, photosynthesis cannot take place because light is not there. But plants do respiration in night also. From this you can get that respiration is a continuous process in plants as well as in animals also. So in plants, oxygen is taken in and carbon dioxide is taken out from the stomata. Moving to the next slide, anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration is known as fermentation. See the definition of anaerobic respiration. A respiration which occurs in absence of oxygen is known as anaerobic respiration. The energy released by anaerobic respiration is considerably less than the energy released from aerobic respiration. जो energy anaerobic respiration से release होती है वो less amount में होती है, comparatively जो energy aerobic respiration से release होती है. That means when there is no oxygen, very less amount of energy is produced. Next, anaerobic respiration takes place at some stage of most of the living organism. For example, our own muscles resort to anaerobic respiration when oxygen is not delivered to them fast enough. See, हम जब भी एक्सरसाइज या फिर हार्ड वर्क करते हैं तब हमारे बॉडी के सेल्स को इनफ ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई नहीं होता है, इसीलिए हम जल्दी थक जाते हैं. जब बॉडी सेल्स को ऑक्सीजन नहीं मिलता है तब बॉडी सेल्स एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन परफॉर्म करते हैं, और इसके कारण ग्लूकोज डायरेक्टली कन्वर्ट होता है लैक्टिक एसिड में. दिस लैक्टिक एसिड कैन बी टॉक्सिक, और ये टॉक्सिसिटी कम करने के लिए हमें ये लैक्टिक एसिड ब्रेक डाउन करना पड़ता है, और ऑक्सीजन देके हम इस लैक्टिक एसिड को ब्रेक कर सकते हैं, इसीलिए हम डीप ब्रीदिंग करते हैं। जब भी हम हार्ड वर्क करते हैं या फिर दौड़ते हैं तब हम जोर जोर से सांसें लेते हैं। वाई? बिकॉज वी नीड टू प्रोवाइड ऑक्सीजन टू द सेल सो दैट लैक्टिक एसिड गेट ब्रेक डाउन। When this anaerobic respiration forms lactic acid, it is known as lactic acid fermentation, and it is mostly takes place in animal cells and humans. And when anaerobic respiration forms alcohol, it is known as alcoholic fermentation. It is takes place in yeast cells. See the anaerobic respiration reaction in yeast cells when there is no oxygen. This glucose is converted into alcohol and CO2, that is carbon dioxide, and it will produce very less amount of energy. This will carried out by yeast cell when there is no oxygen. This is why anaerobic respiration is useful in alcohol industry. Now, next point is, what are the differences between photosynthesis and respiration? See, the photosynthesis is a process that makes the food. On the other hand, respiration is a process that breaks down the food to release energy. Next point is, photosynthesis takes place in plants only, but the respiration takes place in all living things, including plants and animals. Next point is, photosynthesis takes place only when there is light, but respiration takes place all the time. That means respiration is a continuous process. Next point is, photosynthesis needs chlorophyll. On the other hand, respiration does not need chlorophyll. Moving to the next point, photosynthesis takes in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen. On the other hand, respiration gives out carbon dioxide and takes in oxygen. Next point is, in photosynthesis, energy is takes in and stored, but in respiration, energy is released only. Next point, in photosynthesis, carbon dioxide and water are used as substrate, while in respiration, substrate are glucose and oxygen. Next point, end products of photosynthesis are glucose and oxygen. And in respiration, end products are carbon dioxide and water. Last point is, photosynthesis takes place in chloroplast, while respiration takes place in mitochondria. So these are some of the differences between photosynthesis and respiration. Moving to the next slide, significance of respiration. Now we are looking for significance of respiration. The first significance is, respiration provides energy for biosynthesis of cellular materials such as carbohydrates, proteins, fats, lipids, vitamins, pigments, etc. Next significance, energy of respiration is used to convert insoluble food into soluble form. Next significance, when respiration coupled with photosynthesis, it helps to maintain the balance between CO2 and O2 in the atmosphere, because photosynthesis takes in CO2 and releases O2, while respiration takes in O2 and releases CO2. Next significance, respiration is also a source of energy for cell division, growth, repair and replacement of worn out parts, movement, locomotion, etc. Next significance, aerobic respiration returns CO2 to the atmosphere to be used again in photosynthesis. Yes, here the product of respiration, that is CO2, released in the atmosphere, and again it is used by the plant in the process of photosynthesis. Next significance, anaerobic respiration, that is known as fermentation, is used in various industries such as dairies, bakeries, लेदर इंडस्ट्रीज एक्सेट्रा। नेक्स्ट सिग्निफिकेंस, एनारोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इज यूज इन द कमर्शियल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ अल्कोहल, ऑर्गेनिक एसिड, वाइटामिन्स, एंटीबायोटिक्स एक्सेट्रा। सो दीज आर सम सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन। हियर वी आर कंक्लूडिंग। थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग माई वीडियो।